There's a wonderful restaurant called Academe. It's tucked inside the Kennebunk Inn. It's owned by a husband and wife team.
I'm here now with executive chef Brian O'Hay. What are we going to make here today?
Today we're making pierogies. It's kind of a German style or Polish style ravioli or wonton. It's their version of it. A little bit unique. We actually use sour cream to make the dough.
Okay, so let's go. What do we
do? Perfect. We have about a pound and a quarter of flour, all purpose. We're going to use two egg yolks. We have a little bit of melted butter, but we don't want to get it too warm because you don't want to kind of scramble the eggs. So we're going to kind of roll that around. And then, like I said, the uniqueness of this dough, I think, is we use sour cream. So it gives it a really nice texture when you boil it up, and then we're going to actually pan fry it. So the sour cream just kind of gives it a nice texture. A little bit of salt and pepper for that dough, salt and white pepper. Mm-hmm. We're just going to kind of give that a gentle stir and kind of incorporate all those ingredients. When I was a kid, pierogies was our Christmas Eve dinner, so it always kind of reminds me of that childhood tradition of pierogies and kielbasa. I don't know, for an Irish kid, I don't know how pierogies and kielbasa got into the fold, but kind of reminds us.
Well, we got the holidays coming up, so.
Exactly. So then, like I said, you'll see it kind of start to pull together, and you're starting to get that little bit of a stretch. All right, so now basically we're going to do a filling. This is a really simple filling, and I think this is the basic recipe, but you can certainly add and do your own components to it. So the basic recipe is you have a little bit of leftover mashed potatoes, or you make a mashed potato batch, and then you just fold in a little bit of Parmesan cheese. We have a bit of smoked Gruyere, some fresh chives from our garden out back. Okay, so we've now let the dough rest for about an hour, and it's ready to roll out and stuff. Here at the restaurant, we do have a pasta machine, so we find that it is a little bit easier. So I just want to kind of get it thin enough, and then we can thread it through the pasta machine. Okay, so now we've got our little molds cut out, and we're going to take that potato and cheese filling, kind of just do a little bit of a scoop right in the center of each pierogi. Hold it up and pinch around the corners.
Okay. You want me to help with one?
Sure, that would be great.
Almost like a crab rangoon.
Exactly. You know, each culture has their version of this. And then we just take a fork, and we're going to crimp those sides. So it gives a little bit of a design to just make sure that when it's in that boiling water, that it's going to hold up.
And so how long do those cook?
We'll fry them on each side for about a minute.
I'm dying to try this.
Perfect. And we served it with the traditional components of sour cream, horseradish, and mustard.
Fantastic. Chef, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Nice to meet you. We'll have the recipe for you on our website, WMTW.com.